guys, it's Bridget. I've briefly mentioned in some of the videos my fertility issues that I have going on. I have done egg retrieval 3 times, and all 3 times they have failed. The first egg retrieval I did was way back at the mansion. It was in like 2008, I believe. So I looked at that as like a really great insurance policy, basically. And a great excuse for waiting and working on my career and finding the right person and all those kinds of things. Flash forward 8 years, Nick and I would like to have a baby, and we've been trying for a couple of years and have not been able to get pregnant. So last year we decided to start doing some IVF stuff, and I thought that I would just thaw out my old eggs and we could fertilize them and it would be done. And I was recommended to hold on to those as still sort of an insurance policy and instead do a new retrieval. So I went ahead and did that, and let me just tell you, I have a severe phobia of needles. I mean, it's bad. It's embarrassing, but I can't help it. And when you go and do an egg retrieval or anything to do with fertility, it requires a million needles. It is very anxiety provoking for me. Not even in the fact of, are we going to get pregnant or not? That's a whole other issue. But the fact of having to use so many needles, both for injections and for blood draws. The fact that I've even been able to do IVF once, let alone 3 times already, has been nothing short of a miracle for me. So for 2 weeks, I'm injecting myself in the stomach, going in every other day for ultrasounds, getting blood drawn. And then at the end of the 2 weeks, once they think you're ready, then they start an IV, another thing I hate, and they put you under, and then they go in and retrieve your eggs, and they were abnormal. Then we decided that we should use my frozen eggs. So we went and got my frozen eggs.
So today we are going to transfer the old eggs that I had taken out while I was still at the mansion. And funny thing, I did not realize that that is something that you have to do yourself. We are off to pick up the tank at Pacific Fertility, taking it to Santa Monica facility, having them put them in the tank, and then bringing the tank back. I have no idea what the tank looks like. I have no idea how long this process takes, and I had no idea I was going to be doing this myself.
I had no idea it was gonna be this big and heavy.
All right, well, you gotta carry it.
What you got, Nikki?
It's a baby boy.
Is it heavier now than it was before? Really?
You know, those eggs weigh like, what, like 10 pounds each, right? You guys want some human eggs? Some eggs. Scramble them up.
You're trying to give away my eggs?
I'm not trying to give away, I'm trying to slang your eggs.
Oh, you're trying to sell them?
Yeah.
What do you think they're worth?
Probably like $11.79 or something like that.
Is that on sale?
Before tax.
So she said to seatbelt them in.
Strapping in my boys here.
All strapped in?
Strapped in.
All right. Just checking on the kids. Hopefully we can make something with those.
Yeah.
An omelet or something.
Okay.
Oh, the old omelet joke.
None of them survived the thaw. So that big insurance policy that I thought I had from 8 years ago just literally went down the drain in 24 hours. That was probably the most devastating blow for me because I just really thought that those were going to be my best chance of having a baby, and just literally overnight they were gone. Then we decided we would go through another IVF retrieval. So again, another 2 weeks of shots in the stomach, of blood draws, of ultrasounds. and another IV put under, retrieve the eggs, but then ultimately didn't end up making it. So here I am, three IVFs later, and I'm not quite sure what to do now. I don't know if we want to keep spending money and time on additional IVFs, or if we should just say that we've tried our best. So I talked to my regular doctor about it, and they don't think it's too late and that we should continue to try, but she wants to make sure that I'm the healthiest that I can be before we do it again. So one of the things that she wants to do on me for fertility is this NutrEval test. They take a sample of urine and a sample of blood. They test you for any micronutritional deficiencies that you might have. And then they also test you for heavy metals. So some people carry a lot of heavy metals. And if you do, that can be a cause for infertility. Supposedly. I thought that I would share the process of going through this test with you. On Tuesday morning, I have to pee in this cup. Fill up these tubes, stick them back in the biohazard bag, and then put this in the freezer. Yes, you heard me right. It has to go in my freezer for 2 hours. After 2 hours, I have to go to the doctor's office and get blood drawn. They are gonna fill up all of these vials. I feel my knees getting weak already. Are dripping. I did.
What happened?
I stopped breathing for a little bit.
They're soaking.
You have to wait, like they said, 5 to 6 weeks to get the results back. And when the results come back, I will know if I have micronutrient deficiencies and or heavy metal that could be preventing me from getting pregnant. I got my results back from that NutrEval test. It's a huge packet that you get back because they test for so much stuff. I'm going to just show you briefly what my results were and what they told me that it means. They told me that I am very vitamin deficient. What we were looking for were heavy metals, and it turns out that I do have heavy metals. I am testing positive for mercury. I'm also testing really high for tin levels. I mean, my tin levels are almost off the chart. First of all, she recommended that I come in every week for IV vitamin therapy. And I was like, that's just not gonna happen. I need to be on a 2-month cleanse and detox. Some heavy metals that we need to get rid of. I need some GI support. I need to get back on track on vitamins. So I'm going to be taking this stuff called Shellex, 2 capsules twice a day to help rid of heavy metals. Something called BioPure. I have to do 2 scoops daily. NAC, I have to take 3 capsules. This will help my liver detox. And then for GI support, so that I start metabolizing better, I have to take a GI microbe, 3 capsules twice a day that kills off bad bacteria. Glutamine, 2 scoops daily. Probiophage, 2 capsules daily. It's a probiotic. And then for my general support, I have to up my magnesium that I take at night. I need to wear the vitamin plus patch for 8 hours a day. Take some vitamin C supplements for 1,000 milligrams a day. And continue with my prenatal vitamins and some other hormone supplements that they want me to take for fertility. I take extra factors. These support estrogen balance, relieve hormone-related symptoms. Dimpro, this is concentrated support for breast and cervical. DHEA, this is supposed to help with egg quality. It's also hormonal support. So this is my whole morning routine. I have to fill this up with juice. At lunchtime, I take an NAC, my hair, skin, and nail, shiny. That's all I have to take in the afternoon. In the evening, I have to take 2 more Shellex, 1 more NAC, 3 more GI microbexes, 1 more Dimpro, and 1 more DHEA. That's at night with dinner. Just before I go to bed, I take 2 magnesium and a vitamin patch. For 2 months, I have to do all of that stuff. And the worst part, they want me to come back in for 3 more blood tests. Once we see that all of my things are back in the green or even a few in the yellow, then we could try again to do another fertility treatment. Looks like I have a lot of vitamins to take and a lot of detoxing to do so that everything is healthy, and then I can hopefully produce a healthy egg that will turn into a healthy embryo and a healthy baby.